Namah Shriyati Rajaya Vivekananda Suraye Satchit Sukha Swarupaya Swamine Tapaharini. Namaste. Welcome to this presentation on the concept of health and Panchakosha concept of the body. We all know that health is not just mere absence of disease, but it is a positive feeling of wellness at the physical, mental, social and spiritual level. Only then we can say that we are all healthy people. But generally, what is our understanding? As soon as we go to a doctor, we go with some complaint and doctor examines the system, what is the problem, what are the diseases, etc., etc. But of course, doctor's job is to do that because we have to see that the people are free from diseases. But very clearly, World Health Organization is defining that health is not just taking people from ill health to health state, but it is growing in positive health at the physical level, mental level, social level and spiritual level. If we can reach that height of spiritual health, then one becomes a better and better and better human being. And very interestingly, the definition of yoga is also that. Sri Aurobindo, when he defines yoga, he calls it as yoga is for total personality development at the physical, mental, social and emotional level and spiritual level. So it's as if World Health Organization has taken its definition from the yogic definition given by Sri Aurobindo Maharshi. So, yoga encompasses wellness at all levels and it offers techniques, that's the grandeur of yoga techniques. So, it's very interesting to see the definition of yoga according to many other oriental sciences. Ayurveda is a beautiful science, traditional science, 2000 year old science, which encompasses all aspects of health and all these systems of medicine, all these systems of healing look at health as balance, samatvam, samadosha, sama agni, samadhato, samamalakriyaha and prasanna atma indriya manaha. So at all levels, physical level, mind level, emotions level, excretory organs level and mind level and that joy inside and efficiency of all the sense organs, all of them should be functioning in balance. Only then we can call somebody as healthy. Looking at the homeopathic definition of health, we can see that even homeopathy talks about balance of the vital forces. There is a vital force which can be equated to prana according to yoga, and this vital force has to be in balance for health to be maintained, and ill health occurs because of morbid matter or toxins, or these are carried on as taints. There are three taints that the homeopathy talks about. Looking at the traditional Chinese medicine, this also talks about health as balance between yin and yang, they say, which in Indian or yogic language is the left and the right channels, Chandra and Surya nadis. So a balanced functioning of the Chandra and Surya nadis is leading to health. So we have got instruments which can measure this imbalance also. Naturopathy also talks about a balance between the five elements of our existence, Panchabhuta existence, and disease occurs because of morbid matter. So understanding this definition of health is very, very important for a holistic approach. But what we are doing in the present day science, we are only looking at disease, what is the abnormality in that particular organ, in that particular tissue, that particular structure, that particular chemical structure of the body, and go into that aspect, correct the chemical imbalances. This way medical science, modern medical science, has squared into smaller and smaller and smaller aspects of our physical body and try to correct the imbalance, which has made big strides. But we are realizing in medical science it is not enough to recognize this, because today we are entering the field of lifestyle diseases, mind-body diseases, where the entire human being has to be looked into to understand the concept of health, so that one moves towards better and better and better positive health. Let us look at the concept of body according to Indian thinking, which we call as Pancha Kosha Viveka. We are all made of five aspects of our personality. The first and the foremost is called the Annamaya Kosha, the physical body, which is made of all the chemicals, calcium, potassium, hydrogen, etc., which are all conglomerated to form particular biochemical molecules, which go to form a very, very complex cell structure, cells put together to form tissues, tissues put together to form organs, organs put together to form systems, all controlled by our nervous system, endocrine system, and the entire system function in a holistic manner to manage the whole thing. So this physical body, which is visible to the eye, which can be touched, which can be seen, which can be heard, is the Annamaya Kosha, or the physical body, or the anatomy of the body. Imagine the only physical body, which is like a machine, which is not given the electrical current. So machine is lying there, but the switch power is not on. That is the physical body. Then what is that power that makes the body do all its functions? That aspect of the energy, or the vital energy, that makes every cell do its job, carry on all its physiological functions, is called the Pranamaya Kosha. So prana is that life energy which enlivens every cell in the body. For all our cells, for all our body parts, whether it's a brain cell or a body cell or a liver cell, spleen cell, intestinal cell or skin cell, for any cell, for it to do its job, it needs its prana. What is the nature of the prana? It is in movement. It promotes movement and multiplication. So this prana energy has to flow in the right quantity to each and every cell. On demand, it can increase or decrease. Therefore, the cells can do their job very efficiently. So there is a base level of pranic energy that is flowing from the bottom of the spine in the Pranamaya Kosha, which has got its own special anatomy with the left channel, right channel, the chakras, the nadis, where the prana flows to supply prana energy to each and every cell in the body, and cells go on doing their job. And if any part of the body wants to do more, we draw more prana and supply more prana to that part. For example, now if you feel like running, we need more energy in the lower limbs. Therefore, more prana flows to the lower limb. Then you sit and do a lot of thinking work. For that, we need more prana in the head region. But I want to watch a video continuously. So a lot more prana has to flow to the eye region. So on demand, prana automatically increases, supplies more prana to that part, and then it comes down once the job is over. So that is the software programming that is all set into our system, and that is the Pranamaya Kosha. Then we have the Pranamaya Kosha also does the function of carrying out all the functions, and ill health occurs if there is an imbalance in this prana flow to all parts of the body. So what is ill health? Say for example, I am extremely tensed, extremely worried, lot of stress, then all parts of the body is continuously, chronically, long term, working, thinking too much, worrying too much, body has to get increased heart rate, increased blood pressure, lot of prana. Over a period of time, this prana gets habituated to be drawn in a big quantity and gets stuck in a particular organ, and that organ suffers from an imbalance. So an imbalance of prana is when an imbalance which occurs temporarily and returns back is health, but an imbalance which persists over a long period of time with too much of prana flowing a particular part of the body is a sign of ill health. Then comes the manomaya kosha or the mind body. In the mind body, the two major functions of our mind, what is the function, what does our mind do? It does two things. Thinking is our mind. So how do we think? We think in sentences. Sentences are all made of words. Each word is one single thought. One word, one single thought. Thoughts arranged in a particular sequence is a thinking process, and different types of thoughts about a single topic we learn and interact and do all that. So our mind, we all know that we all have two minds. One is the monkey mind. What is the lower mind or the worrying mind, emotional mind, responding mind, which we call as manomaya kosha. But there is lot of freedom in this. Unlike my physical body, on which I have no mastery, mind is like a fluid. Body, annamaya kosha, is like solid. Pranamaya kosha is like liquid, we can say, which has got a direction of flow. And there is flow, whereas mind, manomaya kosha, is totally free. The layer of wisdom, layer of freedom, layer of freedom, and two functions of the mind. One is to grasp. It's not your, say for example, you are hearing something. What I am talking now, you are hearing this and you are seeing this. The information that goes from the eye, information goes from the ear. It's not your ear that is understanding what you are hearing. Ear is only an amplifier. Eye is only a camera. So through this camera or the amplifier, the message, the sound energy is converted into electrical energy, carried along the nerves to the brain, and brain projects it to your manomaya kosha so that you understand what is being heard. After understanding, I want to respond. So if you have enjoyed a lecture, enjoyed a cinema, enjoyed a reading, say, wow, I love it, I like it, it's so wonderful. Or you say, oh, it's horrible, it's terrible smell, it's terrible music, terrible vision, I just don't like it. So we play our emotions, anger, fear, worry, tension, depression, likes, dislikes, these are all the responses. This is the function of the manomaya kosha. Behind this, there is always another layer of our mind, which is called the vijnanamaya kosha, which controls this mind. The mind, when we respond, receive, respond, it has basic software programmed by our birth only. We are all programmed into three different gunas. One is the tamasic guna, then the rajasic guna personality, or the sattvic guna personality. Sattvic guna personality person is one who can work in tune with the nature, who is not intensely excited, sober person, calm person, stable person, comfortable person, maybe more sensitive to situations. So situation he receives, respond in a very stable way, where the intensity of the responses are not disturbing. rajasic person is aggressive person, reacts very aggressively, violently, strains the nervous system, draws lot more energy and has less freedom. And tamasic person has got dullness, laziness, depression and absolutely no motivation to do. But when they come out, they are so aggressive that they just can't control themselves. A typical example of a tamasic person who reacts is where, say for example, your friend has got a small thorn in his toe, you are trying to remove his thorn by a needle, your friend comes and says, hey, don't worry, I'll bring a knife and cut the toe to remove the thorn. So himsa manapekshacha paurusham, when he is out, is aggressive, violent, uncontrolled violence, or he is dull and lazy. This is tamasic personality. This is the basic software programming with which we are all born, and our goal should be to move from tamas to rajas and go beyond that to sattva and reach the highest state of yoga, where we call it as gunatita sthiti. And Vijnanamaya Kosha, typical example of Vijnanamaya Kosha, which is the discriminating aspect of my mind, the inner mind, is, say for example, a diabetes patient is there. He has been very clearly told, he has that the right knowledge, I should not eat sweets, I should not eat junk food, I should not eat non-vegetarian food. He knows, right knowledge is there, which Kosha? Vijnanamaya Kosha. But he goes and sees a very, very interesting dish, rasgulla, which is a very rare rasgulla brought directly from a Bengali sweet shop. So his mind perceives it, responds, wow, I love it, I want to eat it. And then Vijnanamaya Kosha says, sorry, you cannot eat it. Your blood sugar yesterday was 300 milligrams. You should not be eating it. Stop it. So if the Manomaya Kosha surrenders to Vijnanamaya Kosha and says, okay, I will not eat it, I can be happy without rasgulla, then you are Vijnanamaya Kosha, dominant person, you are in health, you are stable personality, you are a grown-up person, and you are in tune with the cosmic laws, and you will develop enormous capacity to understand the universal laws of nature also. And this Vijnanamaya Kosha's job is continuously to control the lower mind, or the Manomaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha and Annamaya Kosha, so that we are always able to go into that ananda. Every human being wants to be happy, is it not? Whether you do study or you do eat or sing a song or hear a song or go and dance or play, whatever you do, it's all because it makes us happy. Some of us go to a lot of gymming, count to keep a good shape of the body. Why? The person who says, "Are, why are you struggling so much?" I say, "You're sweating away." No, I'm very happy to do my gym. So everybody who does anything is for happiness. And that is our basic goal of life. That's the basic structure with which we are all made of. And that is a state where there is absolute bliss. And Upanishad, the Taittiriya Upanishad, makes us understand the basic stuff with which we are all made of is that quiet, blissful, silent state of mind in which we can be established all the time. And this is the field of complete silence, field of complete health, total health, absolute state of total confidence, courage, positive attitude, and this is the healer within for any therapy participant. So let us understand that the whole of our concept is that we all have five aspects. It's the physical body which has to be kept in balance with all the five bhutas, the solid aspect of our existence called the prithvi, prithvi aspect of our panchabhutas, the liquid aspect of our existence called the up aspect or the water element, then we have the vata, vayu element or the air element or the gas aspect, and then the agni aspect, the heat, the metabolism, and the akasha element, the space, all put together is the physical body. And a balanced functioning of all these under the control of Vijnanamaya Kosha, and feeling the sense of ananda at every aspect of our physical body, is the concept of total health. Thank you.